this is my new retractable lightsaber. Featuring a bright, powerful blade, it ignites super quickly and retracts just like in the movies. The best part? It's possible to make this yourself. But how did I make this? And how does it work? If you've seen my previous videos, you know that last year I made a retractable lightsaber with the help of my friends Maddie and Aaron. We used a magician's cane, which basically acts like a really long spring that can compress to a really small size. By looping an LED strip around the tip of the magician's cane and controlling the LED strip length with a motor, we could control the length of the blade. The saber was great, but it had four problems. 1. When viewed from the side, there was an unlit gap in the middle of the blade. 2. The extension and retraction were slow. 3. The hilt was too big. And 4. The lightsaber was made out of plastic, not metal. The next version, releasing later this year, will solve all these problems, featuring a smaller hilt made out of metal. For this version, I focused on just the first two problems, the unlit gap in the middle of the blade and the slow extension and retraction. But how did I solve these issues? First up, that nasty unlit gap. After a bunch of failed ideas, I landed on something that actually worked, adding an additional LED strip to cover the unlit gap so that it looks good from every angle. But I didn't stop there. I want the best lightsaber blade effect possible, so I decided to spin the blade really quickly to give that visual effect of an energetic, powerful blade of light. Fun fact, spinning the blade is actually how they created the original lightsaber effects in camera. Last video, I verified that the spinning would look good, but we were getting dark lines in the middle of the blade.
Why?
That's because in those clips, there's no tension on the LED strips.
Let me explain that real quick.
When we spin the blade, there's an apparent outward force that acts on the LED strips, called centrifugal force. It's the same apparent force you feel when you're in a car and you make a sharp turn. It feels like something is pushing you outward, away from the direction of the turn. The LED strips feel the same thing when the blade spins. As the blade spins faster, this apparent force increases.
And without something pulling on the strips to make them tight, they end up looking like this.
For our spinning blade, that results in gaps between the LED strips and the magician's cane, which visually show up as dark lines. To fix this, we need something to pull the LED strips tight. I tried using clock springs, like the ones they use in ID badge holders, to constantly pull the LED strips tight as they extend out. But this didn't work as expected.
Incredibly underwhelming.
Even when using the weakest clock spring I could find, it was so strong that it stopped the magician's cane from extending, which completely screws up the lightsaber. Thinking of other possible solutions, it hit me. What if I use the same motor that retracts the LED strip to tighten it? By running the motor at low power, we could pull back with just enough force to tighten the LED strip without actually retracting the blade back in. And with a microcontroller adjusting the motor power, we can choose when to tension the LED strip and when to retract it back completely. This was great. It meant that we could have our spinning, powerful lightsaber blade with no dark lines in the middle, just a solid blade. But since we now have two LED strips instead of one, I needed to design an additional motor system so that both LED strips can be tensioned. Updating the 3D design, I realized that a lot of other things had to change too. Essentially, I needed to completely redesign the inside hilt.
So that's what I did.
Hopping into Onshape, I completely redesigned the lightsaber internals. Onshape is the computer-aided design program that I use, and they're also the sponsor of this video. I've been using Onshape for a couple years now, and honestly, it's my favorite CAD program. With a cloud-native environment, you never worry about losing progress or software crashes, and file references always stay intact, which is a game-changer for large assemblies like this one. It's also the only CAD program that lets you collaborate with others just like working on a Google Doc. Onshape keeps getting better, updating every 3 weeks, and continually implementing new features that people ask for. For example, the recently introduced Cam Studio. Now, instead of having to send your files to a whole nother software to generate toolpaths, you can do it all in Onshape. A lot of people, me included, were asking for this, and it's exciting to see a company that actually listens to feedback and requests from their community. Another example is Onshape Government, which is an ultra-secure version of Onshape for companies that need to meet strict regulatory compliance. Engineers in their companies can try Onshape Professional for up to 6 months, in addition to the free hobby and student accounts. A link to join Onshape for free is in the description, so check it out if you're interested, and thank you to Onshape for sponsoring this project.
Okay, so now our design has two motors to tension the two LED strips for a full spinning blade without dark lines. But how do we actually spin the lightsaber blade?
In the previous test video, I just stuck a drill onto the end of the hilt. Functional? Yes. Elegant? Definitely not. so I designed a new system, a motor inside the outer hilt that spins the inner hilt. The inner hilt slides into place and attaches to the motor, and a bearing at the top stabilizes everything. Spinning blade, check.
But there was still one big issue staring me down.
How do we speed up the extension and retraction? I started with the obvious, stronger, faster motors that would extend and retract the LED strips quicker, but they were way too bulky.
What we needed was a perfect balance of size and power.
So I tested a lot of other motors, and I mean a lot. I eventually found these two small motors that pack a big punch, and since we have two motors now instead of one, we get more retraction power, which should mean a quicker retraction.
Now for the extension, I wanted speed.
Like movie style, instant ignition. But the only way we get that kind of speed is if we just let the blade fly out freely. By temporarily disengaging the motors from the LED strip spools, the blade can shoot out at high speed. Then we re-engage the motors to pull the LED strips tight and get that clean, bright blade.
Basically, I built a mechanical clutch, and credit to you all for giving me this idea. At this point, we're all set up to have a bright, solid blade from all angles and a super fast extension and retraction. But now came another curveball. How the heck do I control the lightsaber?
The old version used physical buttons to turn on and off the blade. But since all of our electronics are now spinning at high speed,
it's not like I can just reach my finger in there and press some buttons. Not gonna lie, that was the original plan. For many reasons, it's a terrible idea.
After grappling with this for some time, I had a light bulb moment. If I can control the spinning, maybe the spinning can control the lightsaber. The electronics control board we're using has a sensor that can detect motion, so in theory, it can detect when it's spinning and how fast it's spinning. With the switch on the outside hilt, we can turn the spinning on and off. All I have to do is write some code to detect when the inner hilt is spinning, and that will turn on the lightsaber. And then when the inner hilt is not spinning, that will turn it off.
Easy enough, right?
Wrong. This was a nightmare. Writing the actual code wasn't too bad. Shout out to Frederick Hubinet for answering my coding questions. But when I tried to control the electronics, specifically the servo motor, it was a glitchy mess. Servo motors allow you to control the exact position of things, and I was going to use the servo motor to control the position of the mechanical clutch. Basically, based on the signal we send to the servo, it would either disengage the retraction motors and let the blade fly free, or it would engage the retraction motors and tension the strips.
But for some reason, the servo was not able to hold the right position.
Servos need a very specific signal to set their position, but no matter what code I use, I just got really glitchy results.
I thought that maybe I just had cheap, faulty servos, so I made a quick trip outside to get some nicer ones.
Still, nothing worked. Even with these new servos, I was experiencing the same issues.
It's around 5 a.m. Still can't figure this servo out. So it's looking like a tomorrow problem. Or yes, later today problem.
Days of debugging later, I finally said, screw it, time for a different approach. So here's the new setup. We're using a spring and a normal motor to control the position of the mechanical clutch. The spring keeps the mechanical clutch pushed forward. When this new motor turns on, it pulls the mechanical clutch back, disengaging the retraction and letting the blade fly free. When this new motor turns off, the spring pushes the mechanical clutch back to the original engaged position, allowing for tension and retraction of the LED strips.
It's pretty sick.
Simple, reliable, and the code for this actually works. With the code finally done, it was time to connect all the electronics. Soldering time.
So I finally finished soldering to the board. Now I just need to solder to the components. Okay, finally finished soldering almost everything. Will it work? Who knows?
The finish line was in sight. All that's left to do is combine everything together and test our new lightsaber.
Run into a bit of a problem. This inner hilt is causing too much friction with the walls of the actual hilt, meaning the thing can't spin.
we'll have to redo this entire outside hilt.
Finally, I finished the hilt and started testing. I did a lot of testing. To calibrate the extension, tension, retraction, LED brightness, spin speed, and sound volume, I ran over 100 tests. And of course, there were hiccups along the way.
I think it's likely that we have fried our potentiometer.
The inner hilt right now is a little imbalanced.
We're changing out the gear motor again, because that one's just too noisy.
But eventually, we were getting somewhere.
Okay, there we go.
Okay, nice!
And after just a few more modifications, the lightsaber was ready.
So that was awesome. I don't know if you could tell, but I felt like a real Jedi wielding this lightsaber. The blade is bright even in daylight, and the spinning makes it look and feel like it's vibrating with energy.
Plus, it's actually kind of hard to move. The spinning of the inner hilt creates a gyroscopic effect, meaning it resists changes in orientation. It's the same effect that keeps spinning tops upright. What makes this cool is that according to original Star Wars lightsaber lore, real lightsabers are supposed to have a gyroscopic effect that makes them hard to wield.
Overall, I'm really happy with how this lightsaber turned out.
As always, the design files, material links, and full technical breakdown for this project are free for the first 48 hours of this YouTube video being live. After 48 hours, only HeroTech members on our website or our Patreon have access. Subscribe to the channel and hit the notification bell if you don't want to miss out.
So what's next? For the next version that I'm already working on, we're going to combine all of these improvements into a smaller hilt made out of metal. There also seems to be some internal friction that's making the retraction slower than it's supposed to be, so I aim to fix that as well. Finally, I'll optimize and simplify this design to make it easier for anyone to make themselves. Let me know in the comments what y'all think. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.